When we go into the position of sujood, we're also asked to make dua. Make dua meaning supplicate to Allah. It's the closest you could be to Allah. Learn the beautiful supplications of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Learn to ask the Almighty using beautiful words that were used by the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, or that were mentioned by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in revelation. These are the most powerful words, and we should try our best to learn them, to use them, to call out to Allah. May Allah make it easy for every one of us, and may Allah grant us our wish. But I want to raise the awareness of something else. Whenever you are sad, whenever you're feeling anxious, whenever you don't know what's about to happen, whenever there is uncertainty in your life, whenever people are trying to harm you, one of the best ways of benefiting yourself is to pray. 2 units of prayer and to prolong your sujood. Listen to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says at the end of Surah Al-Hijr to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He says,
وَلَقَدْ نَعْلَمُ أَنَّكَ يَضِيقُ صَدْرُكَ بِمَا يَقُولُونَ فَسَبِّحْ بِحَمْدِ رَبِّكَ وَكُمْ مِنَ السَّاجِدِينَ وَاعْبُدْ رَبَّكَ حَتَّى يَأْتِيَكَ الْيَقِينَ.
We know that it tightens your chest what they are saying. What were they saying? Well, the people of Quraysh used to say nasty things to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, false accusations, words of belittling. They tried to belittle, but they would never succeed, because nobody can belittle the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam. They mocked at, they scoffed at, and the only thing that happened was their own status was dropped. Never did that affect the status of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. But Allah says it tightened your chest. We know it saddened you. The reason why it saddened him was he was desperately seeking their guidance, and he was so sad that they were not listening and that it was going to be affecting them negatively. So part of nubuwa and prophethood is that the Messenger, peace be upon him, was very concerned about the guidance of those whom he was calling out to the deen, and therefore whenever they rejected or mocked or scoffed at, etc., he would be saddened. And the tightening of the chest refers to so many things. Allah says, we know that what they are saying tightens your chest, but we want to advise you. What did Allah advise him? Subhanallah. Allah says, فَسَبِّحْ بِحَمْدِ رَبِّكَ. Declare the greatness of Allah. Glorify Allah. Declare the praise of Allah. Alhamd is referring to the praise. فَسَبِّحْ بِحَمْدِ رَبِّكَ. Declare the glorification and the praise of Allah, of your Rabb, the one who made you. Think about He who made you and He who is in control of every aspect of your living right now, and every aspect of the living of all the creatures that He has made, and think about He whom you are going to return to. That is your Rabb. So Allah says, declare His praise, glorify Him, and kum min as-sajidin, be from among those who are often engaged in prostration. As-sajidin, those who prostrate. So the prostration will help you overcome that hurt, that sadness, that anxiety, those negative feelings. What will help you? Prostration will help you, my brothers and sisters. Take your time. It's a gift of Allah. Go into that position and weep to Allah. Cry to Allah. Praise Allah. Call out to Allah. Do whatever you would like to for the sake of Allah in that position, in terms of the words you're going to say, and cry to Allah. Remember, we're taught how to prostrate, but we're also taught by the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam that we are allowed to call out to Allah in that position of prostration. So get into that position and call out to Allah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us acceptance.